Kashmir, the pilgrims start from Srinagar and then go to Amarnath. Most of them go by foot. They are guided by some holy man who is carrying the emblem of Shiva, and by the time they reach Sheshnag, they would spend the night there and see this beautiful lake which my mother painted there. And the lake give you a certain depth of feeling that you cannot forget it for the rest of your life. Color is the color of turquoise, and the atmosphere around it is so silent that you can only feel that you might be watching your own soul. The next picture is also the Sheshnag Lake with this snow being melting from the high mountains around it, and then as it becomes very very sound of the river, you feel like if it was talking to you. From here, you have to go climb to a path that 12,000 feet high, and the local smuggling, and it became later. At the same time, she also insisted that we must go ahead. And the guide himself, with the little pony, she begged her not to do it. But she was so determined that, like it or not, we all had to follow her. Now when you reach the pass, it is a place where by 2:30 a terrible wind with ice comes, and it blows in such a way that it is nearly impossible to keep your foot on the ground. And if you look one side or other side, then on the valley below you see bones of people and horses who were being swept down by the strong wind. My mother, who was much thinner than me, made it on foot, but she insisted that I should sit on the pony. So the only way I could manage to remain on the pony by embracing his neck. So cutting that, we reached to the spot where finally the road starts to take you down to a valley which is called Panchtarni. By the time we reached there, it was just getting dark. And there was a hut already built for the pilgrims, but the day before, it seems there was a very strong shower there, so the ground of that hut was full wet. And this is meant to stay for the night and to be able to start towards the real pilgrim spot, the Amarnath cave, next morning. My whole body became stiff with ice, and especially my chest, so I could only manage to warm myself with embracing the little pony's neck that his eyes melted, which we got at the crossing. Now next morning we started on this to go through the valley to reach the cave that was smooth and snowbound finally we reached the cave and both the pictures are here, the one, the entrance to the cave with the birth of Amar Ganga, a spring under which the pilgrims take a icy bath before they enter the gate, and then finally the painting of inside the gate that my mother has done in 1940. The eyes she would look on. Sarujini Naidu decided that this must be given to the Indian nation for inspiration. And we know that even his ashes, part of his ashes, were dropped near the Amarnath cave. So different stages, Sheshnag, lake, which feels like the water, like you would see Turka, Panchtarni, which I almost lost my life. And then finally the climb to the, through the valley to the cave where Shiva was good enough to tell the secret of eternal life to Parvati. But dear Parvati was so tired in the journey to reach that she just fell a little bit to sleep and rest. And only the two famous pigeons were replying for his words and became the holder of secret for eternal life, he wished to announce there. And since thousands of years, in the end, pilgrims make the effort to reach this spot and hope to have liberation and blessings. And I am grateful that we, my mother and I, could also do this. I couldn't do it now with this help, but that she has immortalized it in her, through her brush, and now it is the property of the National Gallery of Modern Art, and they were good enough to loan us to be able to have a day with us to this wonderful pilgrimage. The other painting
Rana 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 Rana